Israel Startup Nation, as it was called, were pro-continental, and then Katusha folded and they overtook their license, I think. What, how is it for you seeing that team now? It's not like other teams like Bahrain or UAE where they don't have any riders from the nation that they have in their name. You, there's actually still four Israeli pros on that team. So how's that been for you?
Well, first, being honest, it's obviously being the one who created it and no longer being involved, I will always have my say, but it's great to see the project is succeeding. Most of the people that are running the project are people that were the people I brought up into it, and therefore I want to see them succeeding. It's great that the Israeli riders are doing so well. This is what really matters for me. I want them to succeed badly. I want them to see them being able to fulfill, each one of them has his own potential, and later on be able to pass on this legacy, how cycling changed their life, whether or not they will grow a next generation of Israeli racers or just be an inspiration for other Israeli kids to pick up cycling. This is what I think this project really need to focus on, and I really hope that with this huge milestone of the Tour de France hopefully happening in September, and an Israeli rider being in the start line and hopefully also in the finish line in Champs-Élysées, I think that this will have another stepping stone for the recognition of cycling in Israel. My criticism is mainly on the fact that as a World Tour team, obviously, you are driven by different interests, but also by the fact that you need to bring money into the table. And therefore it's very easy to be focused on what can grow the project rather than just being loyal and honest to the original goal of growing the sport over here and growing the awareness for Israel. I think that having a rider like Chris Froome riding for the team will definitely grow the recognition of the team and definitely the recognition probably of the brand of Israel Startup Nation. But it will not be the best thing for the Israeli riders. I don't think that supporting, a rider in the scale of Chris Froome trying to win the race will be the best way for them to grow. It might be something that will also harm them. Yet to be seen. I might be wrong about that, But I think from my understanding, this Israeli Startup Nation, this point of time, is one of the few teams who have the fortune to be supported by someone who is doing well financially, who is sustainable and is committed to the project. Therefore, Sylvain has his own, rights to decide whatever he wants. If I were the one running the team, I would have wanted to see it grow slowly. I think it's important to have the process to create step by step. I think the most important thing for me, my perspective, is to see that the feeder team, the Israel Cycling Academy, the Continental team, will do well. I think that this is a platform that will really drive a change, which turn this project to be more authentic, more inspiring. They could grow more Israeli talents to step up with the World Tour team, so the numbers will grow. That will make a big difference, as you said. The Israeli team will be composed from a large amount of Israeli riders, to be more authentic.
Well, that's kind of the same problem that Saxo Bank had in Denmark. You had the big stars like Andy Schlecht or Contador, and then all the Danish riders were more or less just domestiques, and we didn't really grow a superstar out of that. So do you think Chris Froome would kind of it would be seen as like increasing the brand of the team, but not, as you said, develop the next superstar from Israel?
I would say, for me, Saxo Bank was more Danish than Israel Startup Nation is Israeli, just by the people. I think it's a known fact, and I always stick to it, that the staff is making the team and not the riders. Staff remains, riders come and go. In Saxo Bank, we had a lot of Danish staff. In Israel Cycling Academy, the Israel Startup Nation, there is no Israeli staff. And the fact that Sylvain Adams is supporting it, and that the team is loyal to its roots and it's definitely trying to promote the Israeli riders, and it's carrying the Israeli flag, and it comes to Israel every winter for a training camp. The character of the team is an international one, which is great. But I believe that you were talking about politics before, and I was, mentioning my own view on how sport can change society. If the team will able to go that next step and bring more Israelis into it, you know, and therefore those Israelis, when they will come back after their career with the team, hopefully it will be long, you know, and grow the sport over here and share the values and instill the passion for cycling in more people, this will achieve the mission. What bothers me the most about the model of pro cycling is that it's not only unsustainable from money perspective, you know, it's also unsustainable in the way that you are not leaving any legacy. If Israel Startup Nation will cease operations tomorrow or in 3 years, what will it leave after it? What will remain? What will come after? This is, you know, I might not be the best person to talk about it because, you know, I obviously have my opinion and I'm focused a lot about youth in the next generation, but this is what matters to me. You know, how do we build stuff that remains after us? You know, that's also part of what I think it's important in the world at this point of time, caring about, you know, what will remain here after us.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like from my opinion or my view that Chris Froome is just kind of, well, it sounds bad to say it like that, but using Israel Cycling Academy because he doesn't want the leadership battle with Egan Bernal and Geraint Thomas. And I feel like, yeah, that's, well, it's not fair that Israel Cycling Nation, Startup Nation should, well, not use because he will get results, but you know what I mean.
I mean, everyone has his own interest, which is great. It's business. At this level, you know, with this amount of money, you know, it is business. There is no other way to see it. And they're all doing a good job. It just, I'm more concerned about the reason, you know. I think specifically Israel Startup Nation, or, you know, at least what it used to be, Israel Cycling Academy at my time, had a different why, have a different purpose, which is probably has been changed, which is okay, you know. This team was created as a cycling academy. There is a reason for the word cycling academy. You know, this is no longer a cycling academy. This is for the graduated. The only question is, okay, are you only aiming for, you know, to win bike races at any cost, or do we also are you still committed to that goal of, you know, of development? And it's okay if it's not anymore. You know, this is. I would have probably gone a different path, but I'm not them. You know, I'm not paying those bills anymore.